This video guides you through how to create rule specifications in Informatica Cloud Data Quality and how to use them in MDM Reference 360. For this scenario, let's imagine we're a governance lead. We need to standardize our accounts, but doing it account by account would take forever. We can accomplish this task with much less time and effort using rule specifications. We'll start in data quality by creating a couple of data quality rule specifications. Now, we'll name the rule specification and give it a description. Now we can start building the rule's logic. First, we'll configure the input field. This rule specification will sort accounts and update them based on their age. Let's set up the logic, so if the account's start date is greater than 10 years, we'll change the account status to retired. Otherwise, if the account is less than 10 years old, we'll change the status to active. First, we'll begin building our logic by editing the existing rule statement. Now we need to add a new rule statement using the result of line 1. And with a few more lines of logic, our rule specification is ready. Now, let's check that the rule logic is valid. Great, now let's save it. Moving on, let's create a second rule specification to validate and update the account type based on its code values. Again, let's give the rule specification a name and a description. First, we'll configure the input field. This rule checks what the code value begins with and assigns a respective account type based on the value. If the code value begins with a 1, we will update the type to assets. If 2, we'll update it to liabilities. And any other code value will be assigned to the owner's equity account type. Now we'll validate it. And after we save, we've completed the required configuration and data quality. So we'll switch over to Reference 360. Now that we're in Reference 360, we'll need to link the rule specification we just created to the code list so that the records are validated and then transformed. First, select the attribute you wish to associate with the data quality rule specification. Then select the Advanced Rules tab and add a rule. Now we'll select the rule specification we just created. We'll need to set the input and output fields for the rule. Notice the Validation tab is disabled when you associate a transformation rule by specifying a value for an output field. Now we're ready to save the rule association. Similarly, let's link the code attribute with the second data quality rule specification we created. And with everything configured, we're ready to save. Now let's populate the code list by importing a CSV file. First, we'll need to select our file. Now we need to map the fields. We'll use smart mapping to quickly map our sources and targets. Check out a preview of the results just to make sure everything is working as expected. Once we're satisfied, we'll click Import. And once the job completes, the code list is populated based on the rules we define. And it's just that easy. In this video, we covered how to create rule specifications in data quality and how to associate rule specifications with code lists in Reference 360. For more information, see the Reference 360 or Data Quality Help on the Informatica Documentation Portal, visit our communities and support hubs, or check out our website.